Ewart Abner, president of Motown Records.
I learned the record business literally from the ground up. I was an operator of a press 25 years ago when they made 78 records.
With Stevie Wonder. And Wonder Love.
Hello, Jesus, Jesus, children, Jesus loves you, Jesus, children.
I learned the record business literally from the ground up. I was a operator of a press 25 years ago when they made 78 records, and I became fascinated with how you could pull a die down on a piece of shellac and make a disc that then you put a needle on and sound came from it.
You'd better tell your story back.
May 13, 1950 in Saginaw, Michigan, Stephen Morris was born. And he was born blind. He was the third child of six children. And he was raised in abject and utter poverty in a ghetto in Detroit. But he had a mother who believed. And he had a few friends. His musical talent was displayed at an early age. He used to grab a teaspoons and things and grab pans like most children do, but somehow or another he was able to get a little rhythmic pattern out of it even at the tender age of 3 years old. So that began the legend of Stevie Wonder. And indeed, it has been a wonder.
Your story back.
Stephen, though he writes about life and its explosion and the mind-blowing experiences and the commitment that one ought to have, he always comes back eventually to love. And this, in addition to those other things that it has in it, is essentially a love song. And it's about two people making it, two people committing themselves, which is pretty much what that man is all about.
All is fair in love. Love's a crazy game. Two people vow to stay in love is one, they say. All has changed with time. The future none can see. The road you leave behind. Ahead lies mystery. All in love is fair. darling war is so cold. You're either win or lose when all is put away. The losing side I play. And all is fair in love. I should have never left your side. Brighter days is penned to write the words again. But all in love. A writer takes a pen to write the words again, and all in love is
yeah. Oh, Steveland.
Your music really does state and say many different kinds of things, and to me and to most of the people I talk to, they are aware that when you write, that you write about how you yourself feel and how you see. And when I say how you see, I mean how you see life right. and the things about it. Right. And I just...
writing, we really, you know, lately have been getting into writing very heavily. I just did a thing that's going to be in the album, which will probably be the title tune. The album is going to be called Innervisions, and the song is Visions. And one of the lines of the song is, people hand in hand, have I lived to see a milk and honey land, where hate's a dream and love forever stands? Or is this a vision in my mind? It says the law was never passed, but somehow all men feel they're truly free at last. Have we really gone this far through space and time? Or is this a vision in my mind? It says I'm not one who make believes. I know the leaves are green. They only turn to brown when autumn comes around. I know just what I say. Today is not yesterday, and all things have an ending. But what I'd like to know is, could a place like this exist so beautiful? Or do we have to take our wings and fly away to the visions in our mind? And this is what my idea, my feelings are about today.
Well, obviously, there's nothing to say behind that, so I won't deal with that. But I will talk to you a minute about Superstition, which was obviously a fantastic record for all of us. But when that segment hit on Superstition, everybody went, if you remember, wow, you know, the room just kind of exploded.
Baby, open looking man, seven years.
he's young and gifted, he doesn't know he's black. He feels a necessity to share that gift with everyone. One of his concepts in living is to help, not just with his music, with himself and his person. Some of the toughest times we have is trying to tell him he's one man and he must rest and he must sleep and he can't do everything for everybody. But then he says, "Then if I don't, will you?" He tries. I've been better since I've known him. Thank you.